Hello friends, subscribe to our channel GDC and press the bell icon for more updates.
Hello friends, today I am going to discuss some basic questions of the peptic ulcer. So here the first question is, in antacid preparation aluminium hydroxide is added with magnesium salt because options are magnesium caused constipation, aluminium salt causes diarrhea, to contract the diarrhea action of aluminium, to contract constipating effect of aluminium. So here to understand this question, remember one thing here. Aluminium and magnesium. So here find out the my word. Here is the minimum and here mag means max. So minimum means minimum excretion, means reduce excretion, and so if excretion reduces, means feces excretion reduces, then what will happen? Constipation. And here maximum excretion, and if the maximum feces excretion occurs, then what will happen? Diarrhea. So remember this thing, aluminium always causes constipation and magnesium always causes diarrhea. So here magnesium causes constipation, that is wrong. Aluminium causes diarrhea, that's also wrong. To contract the diarrhea action of aluminium means aluminium do not causes the diarrhea because it's called constipation. Next, to contract constipating effect of aluminium, that's our correct answer. So this is our correct answer, to contract the constipating effect of aluminium. So the next question is, select the correct combination of H2 antihistaminics, proton pump inhibitor, anticholinergic drugs. So here is the combination of drug and we have to put it in the serial. So first thing is H2 blocker, and H2 blocker is what are the ranitidine, famotidine, roxadidine, these are the H2 blocker. So we have to find out here ranitidine and roxadidine. Firstly, these two options may be our answer, means these are the wrong answer. Now we have to find out proton pump inhibitor. Proton pump inhibitor are the omeprazole, isomeprazole, pentaprazole, these are the our proton pump inhibitor. So here pyrenzepine, wrong, because this is an anticholinergic. So this and propanthiolene is anticholinergic drug, so this is our right answer. This is our right answer. Okay, the third question here is, carbenoxolone sodium is used in peptic ulcer by, means we have to find out the mechanism of action or mode of action of carbenoxolone. Carbenoxolone here basically used, options are systemic antacid, antibiotic effect, orally used antacid, and promote ulcer healing. So carbenoxolone is not an antacid, either systemic or orally, do not have antibiotic effect. Ulcer healing agent is a carbenoxolone. In the classification in KDT Tripathi, you can find out that ulcer healing drug is carbenoxolone, and this is our right answer. Now here, drug used for H. pylori are all except bismuth, mosapride, tinidazole, tetracycline. So tetracycline is a drug. Here we have to find out the except, that which drug not used in the H. pylori infection. Bismuth used, bismuth basically used in the form of CBS, colloidal bismuth substitute. Next, mosapride. Mosapride is a 5-HT agonist, 5-HT4 agonist, isapride, mosapride. So this is not used here. Pantoprazole used in the H. pylori. Tetracycline also used in the H. pylori. So this is our right answer. Mosaprite. Mosaprite not used in the H. pylori. Now the next question here is drug of choice for Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. JDS syndrome. So options are antacid, proton pump inhibitor, H2 antihistaminics and anticholinergic. For the Zollinger-Ellison syndrome, drug of choice is proton pump inhibitor. Proton pump inhibitor mainly used for the Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. As well as proton pump inhibitor also used for the peptic ulcer, for the esophageal ulcer. So these are the right answer here. Zollinger-Ellison syndrome, drug of choice is proton pump inhibitor. Thank you.